Hi, I'm Lisa Catalano, and I'm a web developer and designer. Today I want to talk about my most important development tool, and that's my favorite code editor, Brackets. Brackets is a free open source code editor led by a team from Adobe. It's been around for about 2 years now. It started with a few great features that were unique and new, like the quick edit and live preview. However, it took some time for it to become the robust and powerful code editor that it is today. In this video, I'm going to show you some of those unique features and the ways it can compete with any other code editor out there. One of the reasons I love Brackets so much is that it was created for front-end developers and designers. It has a very attractive interface that's clean and simple, yet powerful. It appeals to my design sensibilities, and because I spend all day in my code editor, that makes me happy. The first special thing that Brackets has is a live preview, which you can access by clicking here. It allows you to see changes to your HTML and CSS immediately in the browser. The second special thing Brackets gives you is the quick edit feature. If I'm in an HTML tag, I can quickly edit the CSS. When I go into quick edit, it will allow me to edit any existing rules that target that selector. It's finding a body tag in normalized CSS, but I want to create a new rule, so I'll choose that. Then I get to decide where I want the rule to go, and I'll choose main.css. When I add some CSS properties, you can see that the code hinting works great inside of quick edit mode. Notice I have not saved anything yet. This circle is indicating that it needs to be saved, but the changes are showing in the preview anyway. When you have multiple rules that would be applied to your current selector, you can switch between them on the right or by hitting Alt plus the arrow keys. To get out of Quick Edit, I can hit Escape. If I'm on the UL tag and I hit Command or Control plus E, I see all the UL tag CSS, but if I move my cursor to the class name instead, I can create a new rule for the class of Y. You can see that the code hinting uses fuzzy logic, and you can skip letters when typing properties and values. One feature of Brackets that doesn't get as much attention is something that I can't live without now, and it's the image preview. If we go into the sidebar to look at the files in our project, we can see in the image folder we get to actually see the image and its dimensions in the editor area. This is one reason this code editor is a great choice for web designers. If I add that image to the HTML, notice how nicely it lets me find the image in the directory and add it. I barely had to type anything. Now, if I look at the HTML and hover over the image tag, I can actually see a preview of the image right there. I love that. Another part of the quick edit that's great is the ability to get the color picker when you're on a color and a Bezier curve editor when you're editing something like a transition. I do need to go into the CSS file to do that. If I go to a color and start up quick edit, I can pick a new color with the color picker. If I add a change to the image on hover, and then add a transition, I can create custom easing with Quick Edit. I just drag the handles to make the transition that I want. If I need some help with a CSS property, I can use the Quick Docs feature. Let's say I can't remember how to add an inside box shadow. I can type box shadow, then get to some help by either right-clicking for the menu or typing Command or Control plus K. I can see the word I want is inset, so I can add it now. QuickDocs doesn't work with JavaScript out of the box, but there are extensions that will make this work with JavaScript and PHP. When brackets first came out, it had some of these wow features that made it special, but it didn't have all the powerful code editing features that developers have come to expect in a code editor. But within the past year, all of that has changed, and you can do most of the things you really want in brackets. For example, you can use multiple cursors. One way is to hold the Alt key down and drag the mouse. This works on both Mac and Windows machines. Now I can type once and it goes everywhere my cursor is. Another way is to select a word with Command or Control plus B and then hit that again and again to find and select the next words. You can also move code around easily when you learn the shortcuts. I'm going to open a larger project file now. Brackets uses fuzzy logic for code hinting and for quick open. I can hit Command or Control plus Shift plus O to get to quick open. It does a great job of moving to the top the files you're more likely to want to open. I don't have to type all the letters to find something. It also has great find and replace features to use across a large code base. I can easily exclude folders and files here, and it tells me how many files it will search through down here. I can preview the changes it will make and deselect places I don't want to make the change, either by file or by line. Brackets isn't just good for HTML and CSS, it does a great job with JavaScript and you can use it for any language. It will lint your code automatically and tell you your errors. This linting can be configured to your personal preferences. And the Quick Edit feature works with JavaScript as well. I'll add some quick jQuery here in the main JS file. Notice that nothing is changing in the live preview right now. However, as soon as I save this file, you can see the change in the browser. I can quick edit to take me to the function definition in the actual jQuery source. If you're working with a large JavaScript code base, it will find your functions anywhere. If I want to take this further and see the show hide function, I can click on the file name to open it in the correct spot and then quick edit again. And it will take me right to that function. So I have two parts of the jQuery source open in one window at the same time. Brackets does not have split view yet, but this quick edit feature means you need it a little less often. Split view is coming in a future release, however. The newest version of Brackets lets you customize your workspace with themes. It only comes with two themes out of the box, however, there are lots of themes you can choose from in the extension manager. If I go to the extension manager, I can type theme and it will show me lots of options. Speaking of the extension manager, this is an important part of Brackets. Brackets is an open source project and has a lot of community involvement, especially in the area of extensions. They allow you to add functionality to Brackets that isn't part of the core. Sometimes these extensions get pulled into the core, which is what happened with the themes functionality. There are too many great extensions to mention, but if you find Brackets missing some functionality you want, do a search in the extension manager and you might find it there. This was just a quick high-level view at some of the great features of Brackets. If you looked at Brackets in the past and liked the quick edit concept, but didn't think it was a powerful enough editor for you yet, I would encourage you to try it again. It's come a long way from the initial concept and works great for your everyday editor now. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions about anything I've discussed here, you can ask me on Twitter at LCatDesigns.